some of you have always wondered how I do my lightbox photos at the very end of my videos, those real nice, bright, looks like something you see in a magazine. Well, I make it right here in my lightbox, and I had this built. I designed it, got some cheesecloth on top here, just white linen sheets. I think it's 12 inches tall, 18 inches wide, and 2 foot deep. I rigged up some lights on it and put a switch in the back. Now, hopefully it doesn't glare you out too much, but you can see how bright it is in there, and I just take my finds and dump them in there. But to get a brighter light in here, I have a light ring. You can buy these light rings on Amazon. I use it for when I do my facial things on some of my videos. But I turn this on, and look how much brighter now. Really probably blinding you on the video. But I can go to warm, or I can go to cool, either way. I like it on the bright as I can get it. Then I can do my white filter on my phone and really get a real good pick out of that. And so I'm just going to go through my setup, and I'm going to fast forward. You can watch it, and I'll stop when I want to explain something. But you can kind of see what I do and how I do it. So let me get you set up here, and let me show you what I do. As you can see, I kind of put all my coins out there and kind of get it decorated like I want it. And I kind of put my earrings on one side, the rings up front, because I like them to be the center of attention. And then the other things I just kind of put over here on the side. And then I just get my phone and get it set up on photo. And then I just start shooting some different angles. I try to get it kind of up like a 45. Kind of get a little higher up and fill up the screen. I have a grid on my camera. You can't really tell it right there. But I'll do a couple. I'll do a far out shot, and I'll do a close up shot, and that way I can cut and crop if I wanted to. I also get a real close up like this. Focus there. That way the background is kind of blurry. And I may make that my Facebook cover. I may get a little closer, zero in on the cart cross that James Avery. And once I have those, I just pull all the earrings over to the side. I put the necklaces to another side, and I'll get all this money out of the way and tokens. Just put it over here in the corner, and I'll wipe off any dirt that may be in there, and then I will take a picture of my toys, and then I'll put the memo over the side. Then I'll kind of lay out my, I don't know if you can see this on camera. Hopefully you've been able to see this on camera. I didn't really adjust my camera. But I'll just kind of put my earrings up there. I don't really care too much about earrings, but they make a nice photo. Just kind of get it where it all can be seen. I don't want that ear part there, so I'll just kind of do that. Take them off to the side, and then we'll get our focus of our necklaces. And since I've got a key on a necklace, I'll put it down on one, and I'll just kind of put this silver chain together on this other side. Something like that. Kind of get it to come together. And again, I'll try to get kind of a 45 degree angle on that and zero in and get it all on the camera. Take up the whole lens, the whole frame. All right, then we'll throw them off to the side, and then we'll kind of position out our rings. I think I'll turn that one over and put these two in the middle. We'll do that there. Maybe I can turn the what they are. 925, you might can read that when I take the picture. You can read the 925 and the tungsten carbide. So we'll get in here and we'll get those pictures. And then what I like to do is I like to do a shot like this. And I kind of have a way of doing these shots. And I'll leave that right where it's at. And I'll try to angle it just a little bit to me. And we'll get that shot. That's a nice ring. And I'll do a before and an after on these silver rings, from the tarnish to the brightness of them. And the last ring. Hopefully you can see all that. And that is how I do my lightbox photos. And now I'll put these at the end of the video and you can see how they all look. And there, hopefully you enjoyed it. And if you want to know the specs on the lightbox, just give me a message and I'll send you the specs on those and tell you the materials that I used. And but anyway, that really makes a professional looking photo. Those are the ones I load up on Instagram and Facebook and things like that. And really makes it really, really nice looking. And I'll come back here in a minute and I'll clean my rings up. And I may even take you in there and show you how to clean the rings too. So, and come back and do a follow-up clean shot. That way we do a before and an after on the silver rings. All right, let me take you in there and let me show you how I clean my rings now. And I'm in my garage now, and here's what I do. All I have is just a little grinder buffer wheel, and I put a buffer wheel on that. And I get this bright silver cream. And I just dip those rings in that cream, and I just buffer it. And here they are. Let's do the first one. Here's the before. You can see it's pretty black. I don't know if you can really tell on camera. This is pretty, this is an old ring. It may not shine out just right, but it may shine up better. And this one's already clean. I'm just going to put a little bright finish on it. So let's get you set up and see what it looks like. Already. If the ring gets hot, which it will, you can just get you a paper towel and hold it by a paper towel. And get these edges. I knew this ring would clean up really nice. It hadn't been in the lake that long. One more time around, and I still got all that stuff on my fingers, but I'll take them to the sink in a minute. But wow, just look at the difference on that already. Just beautiful, beautiful. Same way with this one. We'll just put a little silver sauce on it, a little silver cream. Makes a world of difference. This one's already pretty shiny, I mean, pretty clean. I think I found this ring the day it was dropped in the lake, and it was in a real sandy lake, real sandy bottom. So it wasn't gonna be a lot of black tarnish on it anyway. So it shined up good. It's just got all that cream on it. We'll go wash it off in a minute. I got enough on my hands just to kind of do this one. So let's see how this one does. Oh yeah. That's getting hot though. What I do is I just take a paper towel and hold it by the paper towel. But hang on to these things. These rings will go flying if you don't hold on to them good. Because you're putting a lot of pressure on that wheel. And it's going to have some black on it still, but it's all right. It's an old ring. It's been in the lake a long time. The thing's probably been in the lake since the 80s. because I didn't find it right in the swimming area. I was outside the swimming area. So whatever you do, if you've been grinding on them like that, don't hold them. They are hot, hot. All right, this one's just about done. Whew, that's hot. It's hot, hot. And that is how we clean the rings. And as you can see, boy, it's a lot better. And that's still got stuff on. Let's go wash them off. And even look at that, clean that one got. All right, let's go wash them off. Let's get this stuff all cleaned up now. And this stuff, that silver cream, rinses right off your fingers really, really easy. It's not that bad. But, get a paper towel over here. And I just kind of, this one's still gonna be stained up a little bit because it's been in the lake probably for 30 years. But it looks good. And some of the silver cream is down in there. Oh, look at that. That is nice. Cleaned up really, really good. I knew this one would. Let's see if it might be James Avery itself. I have to look. It looks like a James Avery ring. I haven't even looked at them yet. All right. That takes care of that. We'll just dry them off. I'll meet you back at the light box and we'll take some more photos. Put them back in as close as I can get to what I had before. And we'll take an after shot. As close as I can get the same angle as before. And yeah, this one's gonna be so bright it's gonna even glare on in the camera. Yeah, that looks good. This is my favorite ring, this James Avery Heart Cross ring. And that is how I take pictures in my light box. So I hope you enjoyed it. And now we just gotta post these up on my Ring King Facebook page, my Preacher Digger Facebook page, copy them over to my Michael Heim page, put them on my Instagram page, and then they'll ultimately go on the video. And eventually they will go in all the rings. There's all my ring boxes and I have more ring boxes over there. So, all right, hope you enjoy the video. Stay tuned, more great water adventures coming up. So we'll see you out in the lakes.